Roger Robertson is a world-class runner and journalist and a legendary announcer of the Boilermaker on this very radio station, WIBX. He's the editor and author of numerous books, including Running and Literature. He was a senior writer for Running Times, a frequent contributor to Runner's World and Canadian Running. He's a professor at English at Victoria University of Wellington, New Zealand. He lives in New Paltz, New York, and Wellington, New Zealand, with his wife, women's running activist, Catherine Switzer. And these guys are integral when it comes to the Boilermaker broadcast that we do every year. Mm-hmm. And Roger's written a new book. I just so happen to have a picture, a photo that I took at the post-race party that is actually in the book. Roger Robertson is on the line now. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Bill. And I want to thank you for that picture. And also, you're quoted in the book, I might say.
Oh,
Yeah, nice. Because there's a whole section about the Boilermaker. First of all, thanks. You're a multi-talented man. Thanks for that picture. I was sorry that for economic reasons they couldn't publish it in color because it's a beautiful picture. It shows, your listeners want to say, it shows the Boilermaker party, the post-race party with a musician in front and the crowds all looking on behind. And the point I was making is that one of the great things about running, modern running, and modern running especially in the Boilermaker, is it has such a party atmosphere. It's also positive. And I say one of the things, you know, for me, of course, with my international view, one of the things that America really added to the whole running movement is that it saw the possibility that a road race could be a party.
Yeah.
And nobody else had thought of that. We used to run cross-country in the mud in England and suddenly came to America and all of a sudden people were, you know, eating all this food and drinking beer afterwards and having a party. This is a wonderful concept. The Boilermaker got it. Your picture nailed it.
Well, I appreciate that greatly. And your book is incredible. Talk about the book and what this book is all about.
Well, it was... I guess, Bill, that you'd say running is important to me, even though I've got other things in my life, obviously, as you say. You know, I was professor of English, etc., and education is important to me and students and the environment. But running has always been important. I wanted to kind of figure out why. And it occurred to me that it would be worth somebody writing a history of the modern running movement, because it's really important. You know, when you look at something like the Boilermaker that involves such a huge proportion of the community and does so much good to the community year round, you're not just looking at just another baseball game. You know, you're looking at something which goes very deep into society and is really making a big difference to communities. So I thought somebody should write a history of it.
Yeah.
And then I thought, well, you know, I could write the history, be a huge amount of work. And then I thought, well, I've got something which is different, which is that I've actually been there on a lot of the occasions when running has been important.
I love the story from 1990.
The Boston Marathon.
Yeah.
yes. When I ran the Boston Marathon and not fully trained, and it was the 100th Boston Marathon, we should explain. That's why I wanted to run it, and hit the wall and suffered badly. We won't go into the details of that.
I was trying to
catch those moments when I was there. Yeah. I was there as a runner, or I was there as a spectator, or I was there, like in Boilermaker, as a radio broadcaster, or I was there at the Seoul Olympics when Ben Johnson got busted for drugs, and I was doing television commentary there and had to find the words to do it. And I've just been lucky to be around over a long lifetime and be there on a lot of those occasions. So my original working title for the book was 20 Races That Changed the World, and then that seemed a bit pretentious. So we came with this title, When Running Made History. But it makes the same points, and it's both a history and it's also personal. So
well, the 1990 I was talking about was another wall, and that is...
It was Berlin.
Berlin, yeah.
Yeah, I got the dates wrong. I'm not good on dates, Bill. Yes.
Still, though, I mean, you think about... you take your life and you take history, and there's a parallel here as you, in some way or another, you found yourself running in the midst of history.
Yeah, and that was, in many places, that was a much more serious chapter because Catherine and I were invited to the Berlin Marathon the first year that it went through both parts of Berlin after communism ended, and we spent a few days in Germany beforehand, including, by accident, as it happened, a visit to a concentration camp. So we really got a look at what the miseries that Europe had been through in the previous half century and some of the things that had happened under under Nazism and under communism, and were able to join the celebration of the ending of that when that race went through both parts of Berlin. So yeah, that's a serious chapter in it. And as you said, it's personal as well, because you know my first memories in life, growing up just at the outskirts of London, were of having bombs and doodlebugs dropping on me.
Boy, so
in the wartime.
Yeah.
So those memories stay, and I was I was including a lot of that into it. Yeah. So my main point is, running is not just something which is just on the sports pages. You know, it's news as well. It's history. It can be sometimes important.
The book, obviously, you'll be in town coming up soon for the Boilermaker. We're a little bit over a month away, and the book available all over the place.
Very much so. I don't know about all over the place, but I hope so. It should be in bookstores, and certainly anybody that's around the Boilermaker, I will be there at the expo, and we're actually having a forum session about the book on the Saturday afternoon, the day before the Boilermaker. And so there's going to be a forum session with Catherine Switzer, who of course has a huge following among women runners, and also John Pitaresi, who you know your great journalist from the Observer Dispatch, who's the absolute preeminent historian of the Boilermaker itself. And John's kindly agreed to be part of it. He's also quoted in the book. You know, you and he have some very astute things to say about the Boilermaker and its significance.
Well, John has his own book of photos that he put out from the history of the Boilermaker, and it's really quite incredible how this race has grown, and the fact that you're a part of it really elevates. I think it certainly elevates our broadcast, and I'm sure we'll have you in studio before the Boilermaker as well.
We very much look forward to that, Bill.
All right, get out and get this book. Otherwise, get it Boilermaker weekend and have Roger sign it.
That would be great. Thanks.
Pretty cool.
Thanks very much, Bill. Look forward to seeing you in a month's time.
Thanks, Roger. Roger Robinson.
Okay.
We appreciate
it. Cheers to everybody there.
All right.